something I'm giving up on.
I literally actually can't remember most of it, because it's just you stand, you walk out on that stage and it's dead quiet.
Great voice, eh?
And you just hear you on from this mic and you're just gonna show them what you can do, and it's the most vulnerable, terrifying thing you can ever do, because you just know that it's not stepping on a stage and singing or hoping the fans out there love you, and this is like someone listening and saying you got something or you don't have something. So I'm glad I had something. Say something, I'm giving up. Before that happened, about 3 months before it, I was at a stage where I was going to give up music, because 22 years of trying just got to a point where I was just getting, you know, very bitter. When I entered The Voice, I said to my wife, this time I'm going to do things a lot different. I'm going to go with my gut. I was given a suggestion to sing, and immediately it had started. I thought, I need to email back and say, I get that, and I get the song. It was a redemption song, which made sense to the story with the drinking and all of that. And I said, but if trust me, if you just let me sing this song, I know I can, it can be amazing. Since the show, since The Voice, you had these teams. You know, like before, it's either you on your own or it's you and your band, and you're trying to just get your music heard and get teams behind you, and you hear of these artists overseas that have like a publicist and a booking agent, and all of a sudden this is happening. And here's like a director, and they're bringing in cameras, and people are interviewing on the side, and I'm like, what? I was like, are they sure it's this one? This is booked for me, this studio. Imagine your career elevating 10 levels up. You've sort of gone from mailroom all the way to CEO. The song, Sparks, was just, as soon as I heard that song, I fell in love with it. I wanted it. I knew it was the perfect song. Put it out to radio, and then it just went mad. When it came time to do the music video for Sparks, that was my first ever music video. I got there and there's this treadmill. So I'm looking at the treadmill, I'm thinking, what's this treadmill here for? So Christian, the director, he says, you've got the screen behind you and you're now gonna walk in that treadmill and you're gonna sing to that song. And I was like, dude, you know I'm nearly 40. I'm like one of the oldest in The Voice and you're gonna put me on a freaking treadmill. So we did like a practice run and there's me. And by the end of it, I'm like, so like, after that one, I was like, cool, dude. You get what you need. He was like, oh, no, we're gonna do another like 40 of those. We can't stop. The hands will move around our ticking clocks. Whoa. And from the start, we've been turning keys to open hearts. And there's me. I'm living down the heart of Pierceport, and I'm sitting on my sip having some coffee, and then you hear one of the fishermen down there, their car, and Spark starts playing, and I'm like, yeah. I must say, it was so exciting doing the first one. The second one, though, I'm going to be excited for. No treadmills. No treadmills. I will hold my breath so we can be together. I'm not ready to rest yet. Working with Denim on the album. So Denim Harding is bass player for Just Ginger, which I used to watch from the old days. Whatever he picks up, he plays. And to add to it, he's just an amazing person. He went over and above. And he listened to everything I said. He wanted to be attentive of what I wanted and to give me that and more. I swear, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't scared. And I could feel you trembling in my arms. So one day was this cool, funky track, like acoustics and just a very playful type of song. Tonight the world is ending, but can I spend it? And I go in to do Beautiful Morning. And my wife sent me a message. She's like, yep, I think my water just broke. So Denim's freaking out. He's like, dude, you gotta go. And I'm like, no, it's all good. Trust me, these processes, you think it's like the movies. So she's like, Gav, smash out the vocals. And it was for Beautiful Morning, which is one of my originals. And I said, oh, she said, you know, smash out the vocals. So he's like, what? So I was like, yep, can you put the mic on? So I walk in, he's just standing there at the booth with his mouth, and the engineers, JP's just like, record. So I record a vocal. So I was like, oh, that was pretty good. I was like, let's get another one. So I record a vocal. Then I was like, you got what you need? And he's still, mouth just open. I was like, oh wait, backing vocals. Yeah, okay, press record. I do some backing vocals. Then I go, yeah, let's do another one. Do some backing vocals. I was like, and then maybe there's a harmony here. And I do a little bit of a harmony. I was like, you got what you need? Still with his mouth open. I was like, okay, cool. Grab my bag. And he just watched me walk out the door. He's like, I don't get what's going on. He goes, you guys are powerhouses. And then I'm off home to go have a baby. You know, then we went with Only Lovers Left Alive next, which vocally is just this awesome sort of, gets more of a rocky sound in my voice. And if we're on light, we are made of light, like we are worth the fight. I think we are the only lovers left alive. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. That was one of my favorite written songs ever because of the words and so on. It doesn't matter who sang it then. And Marty did an amazing job. And I loved that song, but the song itself, I wanted to sing because that story was something I wanted to tell as well. I put together this set now where it's just me on a guitar, and I just start from the beginning and I explain my journey. It was in 2001. And at Sun City, we got spotted by Brian McFadden from Westlife, and he wanted to manage us, and he flew us out to Ireland, and the next thing, we're living in Ireland for 6 years, all South African lads. So it starts off with Time After Time. Brian was doing a show in Ireland called Eye to Eye, and he was doing his set, and he used my band as the backing band, and he said to me, do you want to come on and you do that Time After Time? You know, we'll sing it as a duet. And I was like, ah, sweet. And that was my first time on TV. That's why the storyteller starts with Brian, because he had a major impact. And if you lost, you can look, you will find me. Time after time. And if you fall. And just involving people on exactly who I am, because they got to know me through the show, but I want them to understand why and what decisions I made. I will hold my breath till we can be together. I'm not ready to rest, and we can't stop. The hands that move around, not ticking clocks, yeah. And from the start, Universal got onto me and they said, for the album, what name do you want to go with? Silver Skies is what I wanted to name it, because that song sort of represents just being in a place where everything is absolutely okay. Standing in the still. Time, feeling like the world is mine. Can nobody tear me down when I'm chasing silver skies? So if you come to the show, you'll see the songs that you fell in love with and some more. So from having a baby, loads of shows, flying all over the place, having a car accident, and finishing the album, yeah, it was a good year.